compliments are all different shapes and sizes. Blessings are all different as well. God picks and chooses each blessing for us so that it will be just right. The next time you decorate your tree, and as you put up each ornament, think of a blessing that God has given you. I think you'll find that you'll run out of ornaments before you run out of blessings. Every man shall give as he is able, according to the blessing of God, the Lord your God, that he has given you. Deuteronomy 16:17. Lights and candles are used to give light. When a room is full of darkness, it is dark. But if you light a single match in a dark room, the room is light. There may be more darkness, but the light overpowers it. We are that light. We can be the single light in the world of darkness. We must share our light with the world so that the light increases. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all, and it gives light to all the house. Matthew 5:14-15. John 10, 11.
The bell sounds so beautiful.
Ding dong, ding dong.
I just love to listen to them.
Jesus is our shepherd.
We are his sheep. He will go looking for me.
Who likes sin things?
Me!
Let's put these on next.
Candy cane symbolizes multiple things. If you hold it upright, it looks like a shepherd's crook. The shepherds were some of the few people who were able to see the baby Jesus in Bethlehem. If you turn the candy cane upside down, it looks like a J. Jesus starts with the letter J. The colors of the candy cane are also symbolic. The red represents the blood that Jesus shed for us on the cross, and the white represents the purity of Jesus. There are candy canes with three small stripes running around it. These stripes symbolize the Trinity, God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Who knew that this delicious, simple candy was so profoundly symbolic of our Lord Jesus Christ in his simple birth? And she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save the people from their sins. Matthew 1:21.
These are delicious. I love this part of Christmas.
It means so many things.
This feels wrong. This much. There seems to be a reason why we do everything that we do.
I'm so glad that you're changing your mind about some of these things. I have some stars to put on the tree next.
The star is a heavenly sign of prophecy fulfilled ages ago, the shining hopes for all mankind. The star led the wise men to find the baby Jesus. These wise men traveled many miles following a star in the sky. The star was their guiding light to the Savior. God was the wise men's travel agent and source, leading them to the greatest destination known to man, the Savior. We now have his word is our guiding light to lead us to be with him in heaven. Are you going to follow him? And behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood above where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. Matthew 2:9-10.
Thank you.
light, and they were able to follow the star to Jesus.
That has must been an amazing journey.
I'm glad that we have the Bible now to help us lead us.
What's next?
Well, I think our tree is almost finished. We just have to put on the angel.
Imagine you were a lowly shepherd watching over your sheep. This night seems no different than any other. Then all of a sudden, an angel of the Lord in the sky above you, telling you of the Savior's birth. You, a shepherd, why did God send an angel to tell shepherds? Because the message that God had about the birth of Jesus was for all people, not just the right, not just the Jew, everyone. God chose his number one messenger to tell the lowest of people in the world, in the world's eyes, of his son's birth. God looks at the heart, not what the world looks at. Thank goodness. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings and great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Luke 2, 9 through 11.
Our tree looks beautiful. I wouldn't change anything.
The angel was like a messenger of God.
The angel told the good news of Jesus' birth, but what about all the other stuff that we put around the house?
Well, Stanley, let's talk about this holly that we're going to put on the table.
What's holly?
We see holly as decoration during the Christmas season. But do we really understand what holly stands for? The leaves represent the crown of thorns that were placed upon Jesus' head as he was being crucified. The berry symbolizes the blood that he shed for us. He endured criticism, excruciating pain, and embarrassment, all for you and I. The next time you see a decoration with holly on it, remember what was done for you so that you could spend eternity with him. I know that I will. And twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and put a reed in his hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews. Matthew 27, 29.
That's amazing what he did for us.
Jesus must love us.
It makes me feel blessed to know him.
He went through all of that for me.
He came to this earth in order to die for me and you. That's quite an amazing thing to think about during this Christmas season.
That leads us to this wreath that will hang on the door.
The wreath has its evergreen branches bent in a circle so that the ends touch, having no beginning or end, just as there is no beginning or end of Jesus' eternal love for us. Just as the wreath looks the same throughout and seems to not change, so he will always be the same. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forevermore. Hebrews 13, 8.
I just love how it looks on our door.
Yes, it really finishes off the look of the room.
It's nice to know he will never change.
I didn't realize that it had a meaning.
That's a great reminder that even though we change and grow, he'll always be right there now. What about the present? Those can't have a meaning.
Well, we'll be surprised.
These days, the world has forgotten the reason for Christmas. Most people seem to think that getting presents is the greatest thing about Christmas. Other people seem to think that presents have nothing to do with Christmas. Well, they're both wrong. The wise men came to visit Jesus as a young child and gave him presents. They gave him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They offered him gold as a king, paying him tribute, frankincense as God, and they honored God with the smoke of incense, and myrrh as a man that should die, for myrrh was used in embalming dead bodies. These men, these wise men, saw this child and knew that he was a king, he is God, and that he would die for the sins of the world. How can anyone with the knowledge that we have now not believe? The wise men went to the house. There they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures. They gave him gold, incense, and myrrh. Matthew 2:11.
Tree do have a special meaning that would be great for us to remember.
Many people spend hours wrapping all of their presents during Christmas time. They use ribbons, garland, and bows to make sure that their presents are as beautiful as possible. What they don't realize is that the items that they use to complete the outside of the gift have more meaning than the actual gift inside. The bow ties our presents with a beautiful ribbon, just as Jesus ties us as Christians together in his love. We may not be in the same family, but we are all in the family of God. Jesus is the ribbon that binds us together. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3:14.
I just thought the wrapping were to hide the presents inside.
Yeah, I never thought about them having their own meaning.
There's really a lot to think about.
I guess I'll have to look at them differently. I never knew that all of this stuff had meaning. Not me.
People do get a little crazy with the stuff of Christmas, the parties and gift giving, the busyness of the Christmas season. What we need to do is slow down and enjoy every moment, remembering the true meaning of Christmas. Who wants to?
Me!
Cookies, me.
I forgot what Pope said. I know there's not a meaning in the cookies.
Making cookies is a favorite pastime for most families during the Christmas season. Cookie cutters are used to turn ordinary dough into edible masterpieces. God doesn't use cookie cutters when he creates each one of us. He makes every one of us so special and unique that he would have to break the mold after just one use. He is a potter and we are his clay. He wants to mold us into his masterpieces. We only need to be moldable and willing to follow his lead. Behold, like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Jeremiah 18:6.
Silence, God, holy night.
All right, I'm not even going to pretend to know what's in them. Just tear it up. These are just a little token of our appreciation for what y'all did for working with the kids. Again, it's been quite a challenge and really an honor to be the pastor. A situation where you have a young mom that says, hey, I know about this ministry. I used to go to this when I was a little girl. For years, we didn't really offer anything for the wee ones on Wednesday nights, and I really want, again, to thank Chelsea and Lois for bringing Team Kids to our congregation. Give another round. And I want to invite everyone next door to the Fellowship Hall for refreshments, if you will, and then some. If y'all would, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, again, I thank you for today, and I thank you for this time tonight. Father, just thank you for these young kids. Lord, and just for their willingness to come and to put on this play for us, Lord, to honor you. I thank you for Chelsea and Lois, Lord, and all that they did to put it together, for Jamie, Teresa. Father, just thank you for them. Lord, again, we just thank you for this opportunity and just ask, Lord, that we keep your son in the forefront of our minds, Lord, not only this time, but all the time, Father, but especially as we celebrate Christmas, the birth of your son. I thank you, Lord. I thank you for this time of fellowship. Thank you for the food. I ask your blessings to our bodies and our bodies to your service. In Jesus' name, amen.
Cookie!